Now it's his turn to answer your questions. Today we asked you what you would like to ask Mark Eaves about his campaign and his plans for Maine. He joins us now. Speaker, thanks so much for taking some time. You were once one of the most powerful people in the state house. How are you going to take what you learned there and apply it to possibly being the governor?
Well, you know, I didn't always feel like the most powerful person in the state house, but thanks for the compliment. I think, you know, what people are looking for right now is a jobs plan that makes sense for their communities, no matter where they live in the state. I've traveled the state for the last several months talking to people, and what I've heard is the frustration in their voice and feeling like there's an economy that's moving away from them. What I think that our state needs is a jobs plan that makes sense for every single community, whether that's North Berwick or Minot or all the back roads, main streets. In between, we need to make sure that we're developing our economy that makes sense in each community. And you know what? We have an opportunity to build a better Maine, and I think that's going to start by doing that one family at a time.
Gotcha. I want to take a question here from Jim, who's chiming in on our Facebook live feed. He says, do you feel the governor and legislature should fully support and implement the outcomes of citizens' initiatives?
I really do. I think that's a really important question that Jim asks, and the short answer is yes, absolutely. When the people speak, whether it's a referendum question or a bond that was passed, including the one that I supported for affordable senior housing that the governor is not releasing, when people speak at the ballot box, we need to listen. I think that's extremely important that we do that, and as governor, I would.
Okay. Barry asks, how are we going to stay strong on the welfare program against theft and abuse? How would you handle those two items?
Well, I think we got to keep our eye on it, to be honest with you. I think we have to make sure that we are developing a plan that gets people to work and keeps them there, and we have a plan that keeps our kids here in the state. And again, that regionalized economic development is the key to that. Whether it's the loggers in Aroostook County or the western part of our state or the machinists in York County, we need to make sure that we're doing economic development that makes sense for people in their communities, so our kids can stay here and plant roots, and our workers that are changing careers midstream have an opportunity to be retrained and get a decent wage.
Okay. Blaine asks, with the overabundance of laws on the books, why do you feel like we need more? What laws are missing?
Well, I think there's a lot to do. There probably are a lot of silly laws on the books that we can clean up. I think what we need to do is show up, listen to what communities need, and get to work and stick with it. And before I was speaker, I spent a lot of time with families in trouble, and I'd go out to their homes, I'd knock on the door, and I'd never know what was on the other side. But when you stick at it and you start to understand what is standing in their way, and that's when you can start to do something about it. And it's that approach I took to the legislature as Speaker of the House. That's the approach I'm going to take on this campaign, and it's the approach that I've taken to the governor's office with me, is showing up, sticking with it, and getting results.
We have time for just one more quick question. Sue wants to know, what do you plan to do to bring jobs to Washington County?
Well, it's showing up in Washington County, which we will be there. And Sue, I look forward to seeing you, and I hope that we can talk about this in person, because it is a critical issue for Washington County and a lot of counties around our state. We need to develop those plans that makes sense for those communities, and do that in partnership, whether it's the public and private partnerships that we've been able to create, logging training programs for loggers in Aroostook County that I was part of, or whether, again, the machinists in other parts of our state. It's going to Washington County. It's hearing about what they need on the ground and doing economic and community development one community at a time. And Washington County will be there for you, and I look forward to being there.
All right, Speaker Eaves, thanks so much for joining us. Make sure you continue to ask questions on our Facebook live stream. He's going to stick around during the commercial break. I'm Andrew.